Slave Society with another video. Please like, share, hit that subscribe button, and smack that bell for me. That way you get notified when I drop new content. All right. Now, we've been having some crazy weather worldwide for the last, I'd say, around 10 years. But the last 3 years have been crazy. What's been going on in the world and up until recently, the last couple of months, has just been astonishing. I mean, the weather, the earthquakes, the famines, the pestilence that's been happening worldwide. I mean, hell, we've been witnessing and experiencing more meteors coming through the sky and hitting the ground more than any time in our history before. There comes a point in time where you must ask yourself, what's causing all this? Why is all these things happening? Why is there an uptick in crazy weather, floods, earthquakes, meteors coming through the sky? Ask yourself why. Is it because Planet X is doing this? Is it because they're chemtrying the skies? Or is it because God's doing this, and he said he was going to do this? It's up to you to decide.
We've been hearing about an earthquake coming in California for years. What makes this different?
Well, before it was all hocus pocus and black magic predicting earthquakes. And I was born in California, 10 miles from the San Andreas Fault, living under the shadow of the big one. Uh-huh. Now we can quantify this. And we now know that the San Andreas Fault is locked, loaded, and ready to rumble. We now realize that the people of Los Angeles are living on borrowed time. We now know that by digging into the soil, we can go down 1,200 years into the past, looking at soil laid down hundreds of years ago, and we find 10 major earthquakes in the last 1,000 years. The difference in time is roughly 100 years on average.
Yeah.
The last big one was 160 years ago. So according to one calculation, we're 60 years overdue for another big one.
You're talking about the great 1857 quake, right?
That's right. It was a huge 7.9 earthquake that was so big it actually liquefied the soil north of Los Angeles, like halfway between Bakersfield and LA.
And the tremors in that quake, by some reports, it lasted up to 3 minutes, is that right?
So we're not talking about just a few seconds, like maybe in a Northridge type earthquake. We're talking about an earthquake that lasts for minutes. And also the U.S. Geologic Survey did an estimate of property damage.
Yeah.
What could happen if the 1857 earthquake happens today? The numbers are frightening. $200 billion in property damage. That's billion with a B.
Yeah.
50,000 people injured. 5 major skyscrapers toppled because of a gigantic earthquake, 7.8 in this study.
Well, you're not sweetness and light this morning with the information you're giving, but it is important. So if we live in that, people who live in that area, what would you recommend them to do other than freak out?
First of all, don't panic, because the next big earthquake could happen decades
from now. That's counterintuitive.
We don't know precisely when. Seismology is not a predictive science. However,
don't panic.
Schools. I think schools should have a special session to teach their kids what to do, where to go, how to communicate in the process of an earthquake. Mm-hmm. Families should meet with everyone in the family. Do you have batteries, first aid kits, water?
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked the video, hit that like button, share this out, and subscribe to the channel and help support me. Peace.